Ah, there we go. Just needed to go up one more. Whoopsies. Went a little too far. There we go. Alright. I'm kind of interested in figuring out what's the meaning of spawning these levels. Because, you know, they're numbered as early as level 4. It's like just to show you, hey, there's some really hard shit in this game. Or maybe this is just because I actually clicked on the stuff from level 5. Who knows? Like, can I click on this? Yes, I can. Curious George. 4 out of 55. Alright, be on the lookout for those. This is the first level, numbered, that actually has two of these. Actually, that looks really good. Okay, now what can I do with you? But the problem is I can't get the green one up there now. Unless I move the blue one around. Whoops, too far. Around and back. Like that. Now I can get the green one. But the other problem now is the blue one. It was too obvious of a move to make. See, the blue one's gonna... Well, he won't exactly fall to his death, but... If I move him... If I move the blue one right, he'll be safe. Actually, let's try that out. See, he's safe. Now I can move the green one... over without a problem. But let's see if I can get the blue one back up there now. Yes. I can make this easy for the green one. I'm sorry, make it easy for the blue one and push him up. Now I just need to find... God damn it, I moved him too far again. Yeah, there's no fruit in this level. There we go. Now we get the green one up and over. So that's another... Oh wait, but the green one's actually going to be... Well, I could also move them over one, but this is where I'm seeing issues now. Let me actually undo. Well, you know, he has to kind of move like that. Let's keep it like that. Now we move the blue one over. Yeah, the green one will fall to his death if I keep going the way I'm going. But the blue one can't get over now, look, see? There's not enough. So the green one needs to... But he can't do that. Whoops, stop doing that. Okay, yeah. It hits undo, but it keeps the current snake selected. Let's see if what happens if I leave him like that. This is the hard part right here. So I managed to get blue over here. Whoops, Jesus. So that seems mostly right. Green can only go up. Now he has two options, up and left. This is probably another example of and green can get up there now. But blue can't get back up. He's gonna fall after that. You know, this just begs the question, how the hell are these things underwater? Like they have gills. Yeah, this level's tricky. Okay, you know, what is the shape that I had green get up there? Because I need to do that, but in reverse. Okay, it's a Z shape. Alright, so I need to do exactly what I just said. Do that, but in reverse. So green really needs to be... in that L shape, but just one piece further out. Oh, hang on. Blue was already like this. What am I doing? So green needs to be like this. And I said blue needed to be in that sort of Z piece. Watched it. Yeah, I've watched it again. There we go. That's what he needs to be in. And now green. Move around. There we go. So now I can get green up here, no problem, if that's what I want. So if green, you know, makes a three piece, that's easy to count. So blue can go up. actually. Let's just get green up there anyways and see how this turns out. So blue goes up, up, up. Yeah, that's not gonna help. Green's kind of in the way. And even then, green, blue still needs to build a bridge for green to actually get there, because this is... Hang on, let me get the options. Red, please. One, two, three. Yeah, the portal is three away, which green will fall into. So, you can turn that off. We still need... So really, I just need green to go this way. And then blue, you can go up. And green, you can go... Can you go on top of blue? Let's see. That'd be an interesting thought. Blue, you can go like this. But you can't... Oh no, you can go inside of green. Alright, that's neat. You just push him. So when a snake bird moves into another snake bird and there is an open space... they will simply push them into it. Okay, so I need green moved here. Okay, the other thing is that I still need blue to get up here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Which means blue still needs green's help to get up here, so that blue can build a bridge so green can get in there. So green, you still have some work to do. You somehow need to get underneath blue. That's not gonna work. That was close. Got the right idea, but that's not quite it. The thing is, I moved blue too far. So you need to do something like that. Blue moves like this. No, green didn't move far enough. Interesting spot. So if green moves right, he will push blue off. Blue moves left on top of green. Green has no way of getting back on. Same issue there. Okay, that does work. They're stuck. I have the right idea, I know it. Green needs to get blue up. That much is obvious. The trick is getting green into the right spot. He needs to go in a sort of L shape. Kind of like what he's in now, but just rotated. Basically needs to be like this. Actually, that's a good spot right there. Let's see if blue can... Oh, wait. Actually, let's try that out. I can't actually see that many spaces ahead, that many turns ahead. Because the thing is, green's gonna fall off, is what I'm seeing. Yeah, but then green's fucked. So right now the main thing is actually trying to get, yeah, here we go. This is pretty much, I know this is right. There's practically no other way to get green in this position, or at least up to this platform here. So I know this is kind of like a checkpoint area. Oh, there's even a starfish here to sort of tell me that. How far do you go? Do almost a 180. Actually, yeah, no, he can. Yeah, okay. S- So we need green to help blue. Okay, so blue got there, but now we just need to make space for green, and the thing is blue's not even in the right sort of shape to actually help with that. He needs to be in a more stair-steppy shape. So I probably didn't need to do that with green. In fact, what I really needed to do with blue, this is actually, I think, more straightforward. Yeah, is that. So green, get up there, and there we go, puzzle solved. Yeah, that one's a lot more freeform, and damn, does it feel a lot harder. I think that's really where the difficulty spike is, because the other ones are so much more, they restrict you, your options so much more, because you're only dealing with one snake, where it's the entirety of that. It's like the levels dynamically being constructed, it's like part of the level is the other snake, which is controlled by the player, and because these are so dynamic, that's what makes these stages feel so freakishly difficult compared to like the seven other stages you did before this, because you don't have a level to really give you much of an idea of what to go off of. You only have like what, this one block here. You have to make the shape to consider these spikes, but everything else is dependent on the other snake, which is what you control. Just like right now, I could move red, or I could move green so that he could do that. It's like you have like a lot of options, is what it is. I just say freeform puzzle, for lack of a better word. Like, what's a straightforward move is doing this with red, only to realize that red can't actually reach. Boink. So the first snake active is red. I don't know if that means he's actually the one you need to use. Yeah, see? So that's not right. So the first trick is... Well, actually, I have an idea already. The first one is getting to extend green out so much like this, so that red has a path over. And now green has a path. Well, okay, that was actually not too bad. But now we gotta figure out, okay, this is actually where another hard part. It feels like you're in the clear until you realize that, wait a minute, how the fuck am I gonna get red out of there? Actually, I don't even think you can. See, it looks like it's part of the solution, but I could already see ahead of time that red can't get out of that. Like, look, no matter how I move green. Well, okay, maybe not like that. But red's pretty much stuck. Because look, he moves left, he can't move into himself. So you're stuck. So this is not right. Might be close to it, but it's not right. Could be that we need green to just move up one more like that. And then that makes all the difference. Nope. It could also be that green is supposed to be the one to go there, and not red. So green should be more like this. And this probably is the shape that Red needs to be in. This Z shape. One, two, three. Actually, that's pretty much the max that green can move. I'm clicking on you, dude. See? So green can't really get there unless red moves one over. But even then, it's like, well, what is green supposed to do? That is what he's supposed to do. So red can move over one. Of course, now the challenge is, how do I move red in such a way that green can go off him into, you know, actually, let's see. Because the thing is, the green has no option except move this way, which is going to kill him. So in some cases, you can actually say, this is still wrong. Because there's no way to move green. In fact, you could say, well, I should have just... No, because there's no way for green, still no way for green to get back up. Red moves the only way you can go. And this looks like a better fit for trying to solve the puzzle, because green still has options. But the problem is, if green moves, watch. Oh no, red's still alive. Cool. Okay. Never mind. But while green can move, it's really red is the one that needs to move. Yeah, that's obviously not right. Oops, okay, I killed red. So I want green to move up, which means I want red to move up and right, so that green can move up. Oh no, wait, red's still gonna hit it. Oh no, red's fine, okay, there we go. Moments like that is where you want to figure out. But even if the other question is, if that's even the right move. That's not gonna do anything. Alright, what am I thinking? Okay, I'm thinking I could move. Whoops. I could move red like that, and then green goes like this. And that gives a passage for red, but right now what I really need to figure out is a passage for green. The trick is, what I said earlier, making it so that red can reach the middle point, and then red can help green reach the other side. Red is a five-piece snake. Which means even if red was on the platform that green was on, red still couldn't make it. I'm just going to be randomly trying things out. So let me just review the options that green actually has, which is not many. See, I feel like I got green into the right spot. Or that could also be wrong. So red was able to make it. But green's only options now is to go straight up. Of course. I mean, green could go left. But, you know. Only a matter of time before he dies. Green can go up. Then he can go left. Like that. Of course, now the issue is that red no longer has a foundation to not be killed. This is tricky. Still thinking. Of course, the other thing is that I could have been, by the way, there was a giant octopus in the background. I could have been totally wrong about needing to get green there. Actually, no, I'm pretty sure he needed to be there. Because look, red's not actually long enough to get to the other side. So I feel like that's right. And then red's only real option is to go here. So it's needing to figure out what to do after here. Wait, hold on. Excuse me for a bit. Okay. Editing magic. No, this can't be right. You know what? I don't think green is actually supposed to be down there. It could actually be that, yeah, that this was right here. I'm sorry. About having red on top. While green's on the bottom. There we go. That looks right. Now I just need to not fuck this up. So I pick... And then green goes over. And red goes one and over. There we go. Got it. Gonna have to edit out that extremely long period of me just staring at it, doing nothing. Okay, the ones in the foreground and the background move. Whoa, it's got parallax, scrolling, whatever. Little Smash Brothers style thing saying, hey, it's up there. Okay. The camera automatically centered. Let's see. Let's see what the straightforward options are. So first of all, red can't actually get up there. That's issue number one. Because he's only four tall, blue is on the other hand five, so blue can get up there. And red can only get... Actually no, blue can't get up there. Because it would just mean blue is one higher. So again, blue and red need each other's help. In order to climb up to the top, to the portal. So blue looks like it's already got the right idea for what to do in this situation. To have red in a sort of Z shape, like as he gets up there. Kind of like that, but it really needs to be on the other side. He needs to be facing the other way, because then you get the shit like that happening. Whoops. Sorry, Red, I killed you. Is this even right? I just assumed. How's Blue gonna get up there? That's why I'm an idiot. Yeah, see? That's not even gonna work. Once again, we just gotta completely. Okay, here's the easier way to do that. Reset puzzle, there we go. Question number one, how do we get... Okay, I think Red needs to push Blue up there while also making a staircase so that Red can get up there. That's what it is. Yeah, that formation right there, Red could easily get up, but again, it's getting Blue up there. That's the issue. I'm kind of just going to dick around a little bit. Thank you. I got a Curious George just for hitting the cogwheel? Or was it these tentacle things? They don't look like they interact. Or just for changing the settings, because that's funny. Four, no blue. Well, red actually can make it across, but of course the trick. So, no blue does this. One, two, three, four. Yeah, red won't make it. It won't work. It's close, but it won't work. Well, that's because I did it wrong. But then, you know, of course, blue has no way. Actually, can't blue just do this? Yeah, okay. Several moves I could make, of which most obvious is this, basically, you know, leave red stranded. Because red's only four, which means I need blue to at least have one piece here, so that red can climb up him. Go. Took a while, but I got it. And 9 opens 13 and 15, and 10's all the way up here, which was opened by 4. Can't say I understand it, but let's keep going. Alright, well, back to one snake, okay. We start out with two fruits, with pink down there. Fruit salad, 7 out of 10. It keeps doing that. Like, just for collecting fruits that are part of the level. But But yeah, I already gave my ideas to why I think they did that. It's like they're the type of developer that does not give a shit about achievements. Oops, too far. Not far enough. Okay, so this time we need to do a different. Okay, so now I realize what the almost trick is. So I have a 5-piece snake. I go this way, it becomes a 6-piece snake. Yeah, because he's. So the thing we gotta learn about now is the difference between even and odd numbered snake pieces. So it's not enough to climb up the side like that. But it's, yeah, so this is the, I guess I'll just say property from having an even numbered snake, but you have an overhang like this, is that he folds in on himself, but he has no way to go back. And the problem by him being an even number snake is if I do go out one extra, like up, like that, well, first you have this problem. Or if I go out one further, then you have this problem where I fall sooner than I need to. So I need to find a way to fold him without him falling, which is probably to move down one. No, it's not. It's not moving down. Actually, you know what this could be? This could be one where I am supposed to go after that one first. Oh, no. Nope. That's wrong. Yeah, because then he gets... Oh, you know what it really needs... What I really need to do? Get him so that he is facing up. There we go. Hang on, is there enough? Yeah, there's enough. Now, there we go. Wow, I finished that one way faster than level 9. Because there you have like the whole level like carving out a shape for me to go through, and I guess I just read those better than the ones where it's just like big open empty space, two snakes, like one or two blocks that you can actually touch, and then nothing else. So the most straightforward thing in this one is just grabbing all the fruit like an idiot. See, and then trapping yourself like that. That cherry stands out to me as the one that you gotta watch out for. See? So the first thing I really need to do is how do you get the cherry and then have a way out? You can approach the cherry from three different directions. If I approach from the top here, approach from the side here, you get that, but then you still get stuck. See, I was thinking maybe I needed to do a trick where I have to go out and then come back in again, but that doesn't really look like it. I think think I just found it. What you really need to do is skip over some and then come back for them later. Yep. And there we go. Puzzles. Wow, that was fast. I think they should put that level sooner. But yeah, neat idea there. Okay, now let's do 12. Bird's scared of the spike. Of course he should. Probably wasn't even a good move to make. Okay, the question is, do I go for the strawberry or do I go for the... Man, trial and error. You can undo in this game. Just do it. See, right now, the first thing is I am going to die. Yeah, that's the first thing. So the first thing is just figuring out, how do I fall without dying? So it could be like this. 3, 4... Nope, that's not right. Nope, that's what the problem was. If I go left, he's gonna fall on it. And then he's gonna get stuck, see? So I actually made a mistake here. There we go. I like how he has such a smug look when he's, you know, safe from the spikes. One, two. Gotta fuck that up. Okay, so even now, we still have something we gotta deal with, which is that. How long is this snake? 3, 6, 7? Okay, I know what I need to do. Oops, I fucked that up too. There we go. So it's that property of the spikes where it's like, it looks like you'll fall onto it, but you're actually safe to go across. And once again, I'm just unlocking levels that are just 20 ahead. Well, what's up with that? I'll just take a look at it just for the shits. Actually, is there anything I can touch? Doesn't really look like it. Oh, this icicle. And this puff of snow here. How about the clouds? I somehow got another... Oh, it's this cloud here. Okay. Two snake birds. So why is this a level 40? I think I see why. Well, not yet, but it looks like I'll find out. That's why. It's easy for them to fall. In fact, what it could actually be, and it's also the fact that both of these birds are so short. This level is also perfectly symmetrical. Or no, it's not. It's asymmetrical. This one's 2 away. This one's 1 away. So you should probably go for this one first. guess. Hell, it could even be the case that you actually need only the green one to do this entire level. That's always just a thought. It may not even be the case. See, right now green's actually kind of fucked. So blue needs to help out here, because green is in a bit of trouble. Actually, it could also just be the case that that was wrong. That that's not what green's supposed to go for. Whoopsies. That's not gonna work. I'm not even thinking. That's a problem. It's just you kind of just want to move, and then just see what happens. So, anyways, just do the rational thing. Let's look. Actually, I'm just moving here because it's easy to get them back to their neutral positions. Because all blue has to do is this. Four ways. Collect these fruit from each of the four directions. Obviously, this outer one is just way too far. It's not likely, so we can rule that one out. Or maybe not. Now we have 2 3-piece birds. If I go from the left, of course, that doesn't work because this happens. I only have 1-2 moves to make. But it's not enough to hook. Because that happens. Because remember, even numbered bird means that they form a complete shape and then fall into the water if you try to go back. No matter where green moves, up or left or down, he will die. Yeah, and that's the same issue that I keep pointing out, and I don't listen to myself. See, right now the closest thing of a clue that I have is the fact that the purple one is closer. So it's easier. So really, I'm just gonna mostly try to aim for that one. I'm about to push green off. Nope, you can't do that with blue. I can't push green, okay. All right, the fruit acts as a solid. Okay, yeah, he can't fall into it. In order to collect the fruit, you have to move into it. And that's the big question is, how do I move into the fruit without freaking dying? Grumpy bird. Probably a way that I can move green. No, but I do sort of have an idea of what I need to do. I need to move green around with blue ink under him. It didn't really change much. Okay, so part of the solution might actually be this position here. You go down, you die, unless... Three... Right, I remember what I used to think it was that. So let's figure out, does blue get the fruit or does green get the fruit? Yeah, there's no way this is gonna work. Well, I have this one sort of burned into my brain, so I can probably just think about it when I'm at work tomorrow. It's the great thing about Snakebird is that you can actually think about it outside of playing the game and, you know, think about it at work. 13. Oh boy, another one of these little passageways. Probably the main level element. So we have a 5-piece snake bird. This is 3, 4, 5. He obviously can't make it. But is it even trying to go over? I don't think so. Yeah, that is such a holding the mouse to and then dragging it. I think that's a mobile phone thing. They just did it with the mouse instead. I think I have an idea. What I need is Green to extend himself as far as possible so that Blue can fall over, and then extend himself so that Green can fall on top of Blue and make it across. That's my idea right now. Of course, the thing is now getting Green in here and Blue out of the way. But as you will clearly see, Blue can't reach up there. So Green, now it's your turn to help. See, that happens. So what I need is Blue to move his ass so that Green can find his... Oh no. Find his way around. Yeah, Blue's fine. Now we get Blue. I feel like I'm really getting into the swing of things, because damn, did I just beat this level really quick compared to the other ones, because I'm understanding, you know, how the snakes fall into each other, things like that, and then just being able to look at the level, see, okay, this is what I need to do, and also just things like learning to count the gaps. So now I'm better at dealing with these, you know, multi-snakebird levels. Three, so he can't cross that gap. There's no fruit here either. Wow, that one's two. So I need to do a similar strategy of having Red extend himself this way as far as he can so that Blue falls down, then Red falls on top of Blue, and... Oh, wait. But there's the trick. Blue's too short to even just walk over to that portal. So watch. Now Red can go across. But if I make Red go too early, then that causes problems. So what I need is Red to somehow sneak under Blue, or was it a red herring? Whoopsies. And that I need to use this somehow. That is, yeah, that's what it probably is. No, why can't you put Blue there? Of course, it could be that what I really needed to do was I needed... God, I keep thinking... Is that I needed Red to actually go first. Okay, so now that's... I think that's actually just a deliberate red herring. Show this again. I make do this, but then basically a similar strategy to what I just used in the other level, but then you end up with the problem that Blue can't get there, and there's really no way for Red to get underneath Blue. It just isn't. Blue's not long enough. So the key is probably in this platform here. Thank you. obviously not doing it like that. Of course, we need blue to go up. Okay, the trick is getting red there first. See why this level came afterwards. I got it. So blue's head needs to be here with his tail here so that red can get on top of him. That's what it is. So I want blue like this basically, and I need red to move in such a way as to push him in there. There we go. Now blue moves over left. Left again. Okay, this is going to be the tricky part because I still need to make it so that red doesn't get... Oh no, we got it. Alright. It's a good session. Unless do I want to keep going? 15 levels. If there's 52 or 53 or whatever it said, I'm thinking. How many do I want to complete in one night? Well, I guess just whenever I get stuck. Wait, 14. Oh, wait, 15's over here. I don't get why these levels are numbered the way they are. I didn't even bother to look. Let me look at this first before I even start moving around. So we have two snake birds that are 4 pieces long. The main point is getting over here. Probably going to need to use this somehow. Because this gap is too long. 3, 4. Yeah, neither of them can make it there, but 3, 4. They could build a bridge that way, though. Yeah, we could do that too. So we have two ways to get there. We'll have to figure out which one is actually doable though. Completely miscounted. Yeah, how long these things actually are. Unless the trick is you send one over. Yeah, see? Because then I can't do that. Unless the trick is you send one over so that he can build a bridge for the other to come back. I don't even know if that's a record time, but I love how quickly I got that. I can almost brag about this to Richard, saying, "Hey, look, did you do this good?" Huh? All right, without even touching anything, we got 3, 4, 3, 3. Okay. So the biggest problem is actually getting these to climb up. Around these, because 1, 2, 3, fall. 1, 2, 3, fall. That's already the first problem. Because look, even just trying to get them to move out of these shits that they're in, it's like, whoops, I fell. But even if you get them to go down, it's like, whoops, I fell. So the first thing that needs to happen is that Red needs to help these two. Which one should he help? He should probably help whichever one he can help first. Because look, even Red's having a hard time getting down there. So the first thing you can probably do is make a path for Red to move down. No, that's not right either, because again, Red's actually not that long. See, I think this is actually where that piece of blue sticking out would have been helpful. Because then I could have just gone. So, okay, let's undo this. So we only need to move green, we don't need to move blue. That way we can do this. Oh shit, yeah. So now green can move up. And red can move through. Now the next question is, how do we move blue? No, that's right. So I'll do that. So now the next question is, we need to move blue. That won't work. Wait, yeah, it will. What the fuck am I talking about? So now I feel like I need to do the same thing, but this time, wait a minute. Yeah, I can make it across that safely. So now blue can get over here. Green can get up there. Larger move count compared to the other one, but three, four. Oh, wait. I don't even know if red can make it up that. But, anyways, I think I got it. Actually, first let's undo that so that blue can do that. And now we can have green. There we go. Oh, I overthought it. You can just go straight in. Two, three, four, five. Let's see. This could be one where you need red to push green up, so he goes over, green comes over here. here helps red, down here. No, there's the trick. Green needs to come down here because red is two. Or will he move into this before we fall in it? Either way, I know I have one idea. We need to push green up. So green's over. That's already a problem right there. Is how the hell does green actually get down there? Because that happens. Yeah, so anyways, green gets down here. I think we do need red down there first. Let's just see. Okay, so we get that. It also could have been that I didn't actually need green to go over. I just needed to green to go like this. Yeah, red will fall onto that, okay. Green moves, you know, one down, this tail hangs over and he falls. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking about green. Is there a way that green can be like this, but in reverse? So it could also be that we need to bring red over the top. Actually, no. I don't see how, because it takes red in order to even get green up there. So actually, never mind, I'm wrong. There is a way to get red up there. And I just did it. Whoops, fuck that up. Let's just go back to the beginning. Which is the faster way is doing this. Alright, so I can get both of them here. Now it's from there, it's what to do about it. Leave a little gap for red to fall through. Let's just try it. No, red, green still dies. So it's not actually, or did that, I could have done it wrong. Nope, it's mostly right. Here in order to have green go down that way, which means I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the same either way. Which means if green comes from the top, he has 4 this way, 1 this way, 1 this way. Way. It's the same problem. Green can't even come from the top here. So is it necessarily the case that red must be on the bottom? Wait, green is coming from this, from the right here. So yeah, red does need to be down there, but green needs to make his way back around. And that's the other problem. How do I get green back? Well, never mind. That's not a problem. Green can just walk to the other side. There could be a problem from red being upside down, but we'll see. There we go. Yeah, see, if red was up, I think red could actually just move right in there with no problems. Just looking at just to see. Okay, there's ultimately two ways I can do it. But, okay. Neither of them really work out too well. Oops. Because green can't come back. So I got that the way I wanted it to. Of course, the problem, as I already said, is green has nowhere to move. It could also be that I just need to use green as a temporary platform. Like that. And then I can get green to do his thing. Like that. Goes red. Now I make my way to the other side. And there we go. Hang on. So, go in red. Nope, that's not right. Close, but not quite. So I need red's help in getting him like that. I can then, there we go. Now green's in the clear. What the fuck? I need green to do this. The fold over trick that you learned in the earlier levels. And there we go. Star 6. Jesus, what is that like? Oopsies. Oh, there's a fruit. Oh, no, yeah, that's a snakebird. I somehow thought that was like a oddly shaped lemon. Couldn't see the blue snakebird on the blue background. Forgive me. Curious George. Can I touch the birds too? But anyways, we have these. Can you touch these? Let me see blue if can blue can move that. Oh my god, this is nuts. We've got box boy shit over here. Okay, let's take another look at this crazy ass level here. I want to get up to that top. This involves moving these platforms to have bridges so that we can actually get up there. Right now, Green is in a position where he cannot move at all. I hit every key, he can't move. Because Red's in the way, so only thing Red can do is that, so that Green can move up, like that. Red can then proceed to move up and fall down, like that, and then he can also move over, like that. Green, and he can follow behind Green doing whatever Green needs to do. Question is, okay, you can move in between that. So that's a really interesting structure, which means blue can actually lift green up there. Wow, that's cool. So now green's up here, which means blue moved around. Blue could just as easily do the same thing for red. Of course, I also think I want to help green get to the other side here. So I help blue over, or get red over. And then green can come over here. Here's a question. Oh, yep, you can. So it is just like a kind of a dead snake bird where you can move into it. It doesn't act as a solid wall. Now the question is, how do I get blue up here? Because if green pushes this block, you know, that's just all well and good, but that only makes it so that red can get over here without needing blue's help. See, you can't move that, which means that's really the only place it could fall to. We also have this here. Yeah, gotta remember that. You can actually do that with it. Just trying to figure out. Wait, can green move into it though? I don't think he can. Nope. So that is where that pretty much where that piece goes. Question of course remains, how do we get blue out of there? There's no fruit in this level. So, you know, red can get up here, Woohoo. Oh, I got an idea. We need green to sort of help lift, hold it up while blue comes up here. That's what we gotta do. So my guess is, no, he can't. Blue can't do that. So then green holds it. Then blue moves away. You can probably get red over there. Okay, that might have been a bad move. Blue goes like this. Nope, blue cannot lift it up. Which means, oh, it's because he's on top of the other one. Whoa. Trippy. I could have just fucked things up. Yeah, you can't go in there. That's pretty much a death trap. Yeah, green can't even get down there, so blue just can't do that. I'm sorry, green can do that, but gotta be careful with how we move blue. So green, hold that. Let's see, blue can go up, of course. Oh shit. Wait. Blue can push that. Which makes that. Which means I actually can. Okay, well, I can't do that, but the idea is I actually can get some help for getting out of here. Thank you. Or not. I'm tempted to restart, but I feel like I've gotten so close that it might not be worth it. There. Haha! Look at that shit. Now the question is, of course, if Green can even get the fuck up here. So good. I did such a cool move and it didn't work. I forget blue is here, so. There we go. Now we just gotta find out how to get up there. That's the tricky part. This whole thing needs to be done with, you know, three-piece snake birds. Anyways, I feel like I'm really close. I kind of feel like I fucked up something with this block here. No, it was here, so you could only move it one tile. It's like, it can't be right. And even if you move this over one, it's not even the issue. Unless what I need to do is somehow move that block down there, up here. Like, see this block here? And, like, that should have been up top here. That's probably what I needed to do. I'm okay with restarting. So, like I thought before, the first thing is... Yeah, because if it's here, then I can push it here, and then they can all three get up there. Yo, fuck. That's not what I needed to do. That's what I needed to do.
Thank you.
Oops. Thank you. this block used to be down here, which was how I was able to do that part before. So what I actually need to do is lift it one and push it to the side. Yeah, that's what I gotta do. Yeah, I don't have to worry about it falling anymore, it's hooked. So blue can move freely. Problem is that block makes it so that I can't push it back. Blue can afford to push it once. No, he can't push it twice. So that block does need to go down there, but I think I did it too early. Yeah, because there's no other way to possibly push it. So this level needs a reset. I actually probably should end this session once I solve this puzzle because I can hear my laptop's fan running. So now red can get across. Now the choice is, do I want to use... I actually could push that thing right now. This elevator block. I feel like this is the kind of puzzle where there's like many ways to do it. Actually could push this left, sneak this one under, and save that one for later. Yeah, this one I'll save for later. Right now I'm just pick one, stick to it, and see how far I can get. Now the main challenge would be to find a way to get blue up to the top. So I got my three players in place. So here we go. Green moves it over one. Blue. It up. Green will hold it. Blue. Can I push green? Yes, but that happens. In fact, red has the opportune spot to do this, and now blue is in the clear. Now the thing is getting red up there. Which I can do this. Green can not move that up any higher for some reason, even though there's nothing in the way. Wait a minute. Yeah, okay. So for some reason green can't move it up any higher. I feel like that was right, but I'm gonna look at it again. Just to be sure, that might have just only been right for green. Thank you. Blue's in the clear. Blue didn't even need to go up there. I just needed green down here. Wait, I'm gonna... Hang on, let's just try it. There we go. Oops. No, then I'll get stuck. Blue, get your ass over here. So before I do that, no. And there we go. Wait. No. That does need to be up there. Sucks when you realize at like the last moment that no, that's not what that piece is for. Well, I can also just stair stack them in a way so they can all get up there. We'll see how that works out. See, chances are I actually needed that up there. Thank you. So where do I need this? I need this here. Can't be right. Is there any other way to get up there? Thank you. you still have to do the same thing of pushing it all the way to this sign. Sometimes I feel like maybe I wasn't supposed to drop this down here. Could be that. Need to rethink my whole approach. But yeah, really cool puzzle there. I should probably call it a session though, but I just got addicted to this game. He's not the one you want to do that with. Blue is. Mm-hmm. No, it happens with blue too. So that L shape is death. That doesn't work either. Perhaps I need to go over. Nope. Do it all. Can you actually do the same with blue? No, you cannot. See, blue's too tall. Death. Oh no, hang on, I got it. No, you're eternally stuck. So even when you find out the main trick, it's figuring out what to use that for. Even that still kills him. What if you did that? This is another good one too. Let me look at these blocks. But of course, I think I just realized it now because I'm not paying attention. You want to do this. There we go. That way green has something to stand on. Almost. Go this way. Death on the next move. Go up, death on the next move. This one should not be giving me that much of a hard time. Like, I think what just happened was I had the right answer and then I just backed away from it. So, like, that feels right. This feels right minus the part that he's facing this way. So what I probably need to do is something more like this. Will he reach? I don't think he will. No, he won't. See? Even if I do it this way, same problem. The first decision is deciding which snake bird you want to send in first. Because they can't. Wait a minute, they can go over. That's how you get them over. Well, when you don't do it wrong. Actually, no, you can't. Because even if I had that one extra shape from having an L, still too tall, so we can confirm that going over is not the way. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, even going straight up, they would only make it here. So we know for a fact it's not that way. You know for a fact, blue it does not go first, because either way you send blue gets trapped. So it has to be green. This has to be the first move that you need to do. That would be the next major one if it wasn't for the fact that I needed two more moves. But yeah, I said I needed to call it a session, and so I will.